Hello friends, this is a dual 2-in-1 soldering and rework station sold by INDE Enterprises. Two channels, one is for soldering, other one is for SMD reworking. It's a very powerful soldering and rework station. So first we will show you the maximum and minimum temperature range of soldering. Soldering iron is connected with the help of this metallic connector to the main unit. We can use this up button for increasing the temperature. Maximum temperature in is 450, but can be increased to 500 using different mode. And the minimum temperature range we can achieve by pressing this down button. Which is 200 degree. However, by using a different mode, we can achieve minimum temperature of 100 degree. Preferable temperature for general purpose soldering is 350 degree. It will achieve the set temperature slowly. See, it's having a dual display for a set and actual temperature. This is display is for set temperature, other one is for actual temperature. Now we move to second channel, which is for hot air. As soon as we pick this handle from the support rack, the second channel is activated. With the help of this up and down button, we can increase the temperature. The maximum temperature range is 500 degree and minimum temperature is, we'll show you, we'll keep pressing this down key, minimum temperature is 100 degree. So the temperature range for hot air is 100 to 500 degree. We will just move to 300 degree. Similarly, we can also control airflow of this hot air iron. The maximum hot air flow per minute is 120 liter and the minimum is 1 liter. So the hot air flow range is 1 to 120 liter per minute. We can choose the hot air airflow according to our choice. As soon as we keep this handle on the support rack, the sensor detects the handpiece and the temperature gradually decreases, and after achieving a temperature of 100 degree centigrade, this second channel will be switched off. It will go to the standby mode. Now you can see the temperature is decreasing, and as soon as it reaches 100 degree centigrade, this second channel for hot air will be switched off automatically. It will be switched on as soon as we pick this hot air iron from this support rack. See, the second channel has been switched off and it is now in standby mode. Different type of hot air nozzles for different type of ICs are provided along with this unit. These three nozzles are part of default supply. Other nozzles are optional and one can buy according to his need. We will show you how to connect this hot air nozzle with this. It is very simple push to fit type nozzles, and we can remove this nozzle by using this support rack. Now we will move to the soldering part. Different type of soldering bits are provided, like this cavity type soldering bit for SMD soldering, knife type bit for SMD soldering, chisel type for different type of soldering application, slope type for solar application and this extra wide soldering bit for high mass application. So as I explained earlier, it is having a dual display for set and actual temperature, and I already explained the maximum and minimum temperature range. Now we'll move to next step, and we will show you how to calibrate this unit. Calibration is often required for to maintain the quality standards. For calibration, we need to measure the tip temperature with the help of this external calibrator. We will use fresh solder. We will wet it with fresh solder and check the actual tip temperature, which is close to 340. However, the set temperature is 350, so there is a variation on the downside around 10 degrees centigrade. We will calibrate this unit and we will show you how it is calibrated. First, we need to press this star button and press this up and down button, and now it is entered into the calibration mode. We need to enter the exact value which we have observed on the calibrator. That was 340 degree. By using the down button, we can achieve that value 340. Then again press the star button. Then the calibration is working right now, and we will verify whether the value which we have entered has been accepted by the controller, and we will check the actual temperature once again. See, the set temperature is 350 and actual temperature is close to 350. So unit is now calibrated and within the tolerance limit. A very useful feature of password locking is also available with this unit, and we can lock this soldering channel, and we can prevent the user or any unauthorized person to change the temperature without the permission of the supervisor. See how it is enabled. We will show you step by step. First, we need to switch this channel 1 off, then press this up and down button simultaneously and switch the unit on. Now the three dot will be displayed on the screen. First, then we need to press the star button. This 000 is the default password. We need to press star button once again, and then we need to press this up or down button to enter a new password. New password, suppose we select 10 as new password. We need to repeat this step once again. Again press the star button, and by using the up button, we can enter numeric digit 10, then again press star button. Now the password has been set to 10. Earlier it was 000. Now to activate this locking feature, we need to switch the unit off and switch it on again. And now we can see that even after pressing this either of this up or down button, we cannot increase or decrease the temperature. This is a very useful feature which is not present in other models available in the market. So we would recommend for you to buy this unit if you are using through hole or assembly type components, and it is used for both for soldering and reworking application. So that's all we have right now. Thanks for watching.